Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you are new. So today I am back with another video that I have not done in a long time, which is a good thing, but it is another cancer vlog. So if you're new here, you might not know, last June I was diagnosed with osteosarcoma, which is a form of bone cancer, and I got surgery, blah blah blah. If you want to get caught up with that, go watch my other cancer vlogs. I have a playlist, it'll explain a lot, and then come back and watch this one. But I have not been updating as much because there just hasn't been a lot to talk about, which is a good thing. Like, it's not bad, like, that's good. But when there is something I need to tell you guys, something that's bothering me, or news, or an update, I would like to talk about it with you, so that's what I'm doing today. So, to start off, if you guys did not know, I went to LA on the 13th of June, and prior to that, like a week before, I had found a bump on my left shin, so like right here. And with osteosarcoma, it is really common in like the long bones, so like your like arms, your shin, like your leg area. That's where it's pretty common, that's where most tumors are found. So when I found it, I was really nervous. My mom wasn't home, so I like went to my sister. I was like, Olivia, like, feel my leg, like, is this weird, like, should I be worried? And she's like, call mom right now. And we had to schedule an appointment, but since I had already booked my flight to LA and everything was planned, I was like, I'm going, like, health aside, I'm gonna go to LA. Was it a good idea? Probably not. Health should come first. But we ended up planning this, well, like, making this appointment for after I came back from LA. And I typically go every month, every 2 months for like scans, which are like MRI, a lung CT, x-rays of my legs and my wrists, and then, and then blood work. That's not a scan, but like blood work. And then I always have a meeting, that sounds wrong, an appointment with my oncologist, like a consultation, that's what it's called, with my oncologist, which is like a cancer doctor. Fun. So I do that every month anyways, but now I have a specific reason and we wanted it to be sooner, and when we called, they're like, yes, get in, like, because any bump, they're like, we need to check it out, like, we need to make sure it's okay. And so we made an appointment for after LA, which was gonna be sometime in July. I don't remember the exact date of the appointment, I'm sorry. So I went in and I got all of my regular scans. They also checked out my shin and they decided to just keep a close eye on it, make sure everything was okay. But that's not the reason I'm updating you guys. So you guys could probably tell on social media I have been very different. I've been not as like peppy, woohoo, go team, woo, you know? I've been kind of down, I've been less active, you know? And that's just something I do when I get anxious, stressed, sad, just because I don't want to put that negativity out there to you guys. But that's how I've been feeling lately. So I took a little, like, I'm taking a breather, but basically, we got some not so great news from my doctors. Basically, every month I get an MRI. It's a scan, whatever, magnetic resonance image, something like that. Something to do with magnets, that's what an MRI is. Look it up if you don't know. But I always get it of my wrist area, my wrist, hand, arm, whatever. Usually they all turn out fine, like it's no big deal, like they just check it for the healing post-op, you know, like to see if everything's connecting well, you know. But I went in for my consultation, not really expecting anything out of it, just another like, oh, you're good to go, see you next month. But she had brought up that they found something on my scan that was abnormal. And I'll put a picture up, but I mean, it's kind of hard to see. It's really only visible to a trained eye. I mean, these people have been looking at MRIs for years, so they know what to look for, what's normal, what's not normal. And there was a little spot. I'm gonna go on my portal and I'm gonna try to find out how big it was because I had the dimensions on there. So I have the MRI up, and it was a 10.3 by 6.9 millimeter abnormality. And so they don't know exactly what it is, but in the report, I'll read what it says. There's a 10 millimeter by 7 millimeter nodule area of ill-defined decreased T1 signal along the volar and radial aspect of the distal aspect of the blah 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 graft. That's a lot of doctor words, I know. Basically what they're saying is there was a little spot which is ill-defined, like it's not like super big, on my wrist bone where I had the bone graft. They said it may have been present on past MRIs, but it had never been noticed because it just increased in size. And obviously that's worrisome because tumors, obviously they grow. They start from something super, super tiny and they grow. I mean, mine I had had for a couple of years and it got to be huge. It was like, you know, it wasn't actually like that. But it said it may be a recurrent tumor and or like residual tumor, so like something, so it could either have come back or it could have been like a little something left over. Because I feel like, I mean, doctors correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like I remember my orthopedic surgeon saying something like, with my tumors they have like little tentacles and like they kind of like have just like teeny tiny cancerous cells. And so he tried to get like clean margins, but maybe that wasn't the case and something was left over so tiny that they couldn't see it. My oncologist talked to me about it, and obviously I take news well just because I'm like, okay, I'm ready to go. Like, what are we gonna do about it? But it's hard to hear, like, you thought you beat something and the fact that it might be back, something as scary as this, it's hard, but we're gonna fight it like family, am I right, folks? But she wanted to show it to my orthopedic surgeon who specializes in cancer, so she wanted to discuss it with him, and then she thought it was a good idea to get another CT. And I don't know, I think the CT will be with contrast dye, I don't know if it will be, but I hate that stuff, it makes you feel like you have to pee, it makes your body really hot, it's weird. But it might be with that, I'm just not sure. Unfortunately, my orthopedic surgeon was out for a week, so I had to sit here in agony waiting to know what this is. I still don't know, but that's what I'm getting to. So he ordered another CT for tomorrow, and I have been fine previously just because it hadn't really hit me yet, but now that the day is approaching that I might find out if I have more cancer or not, it's just been really weighing on me. I'm sorry. So I get my CT tomorrow, they're gonna look at it, and then they may continue on to get another biopsy, which is where they stick a little needle and get a sample of the tumor, the spot, whatever it is. I don't know exactly what it's gonna be. I don't know what the future holds. It could be cancer, it could not be. You never know. We will find out very soon, and I definitely, definitely, definitely will keep you guys updated because you guys are my family. You deserve to know what's going on. But it may not seem like a big thing to you guys, but after you've gone through something like this, you won't understand what it's like to like know if it's coming back, you know? It sucks. But yeah, I really hope it's not. I will try to take you guys along with me tomorrow, just the appointment, and talk to you guys after the scan. But I just wanted to talk to you guys, get some things off my chest. You guys deserve to know what's going on and why I've been so upset and distant from you all, which I hate being distant from you guys because, like, you guys are, like, my happiness. But yeah, so I just wanted to come on here and explain why I've been upset lately. It's just been hard to, like, process, I guess. It may seem dumb to you guys, I don't know, but it's not dumb to me. Anyways, I'm gonna leave you guys with that, and we'll see what tomorrow holds for me. Bye, guys. Hey, guys. So, it's the day after. Sorry if I sounded really tired in my last clip. I was just highly emotional and very tired. So, that's the tea, sister. I do feel a lot better now that I have that out of the way. I'm still, like, anxious to know what's going on. I'm just trying not to think about it right now. I thought they would call me like afterwards, because I mean it's the day after. If I didn't already say that already, I'm sorry, I don't know. But they said they would call me and it would take like 4 hours. They didn't call me yesterday, they haven't called me yet today, and it is 4:30, so I have to wait in agony some more. I love that. But yeah, I'm just trying to keep my mind off of things. I don't want to think about it. It's weird. But as soon as I know, I will update you guys. I'm just waiting for that call, you know? It's very busy down there. My doctors are very busy people. I'm just hoping my orthopedic surgeon gets to see it very soon, because I know he's going to be in the OR until the 31st, starting tomorrow, I believe. So I just hope he gets to it today. Let's pray, because I can't wait a week. I can't do that. I forgot to mention, the CT went well. I had to wait for like ever, but that's okay. I did not have contrast, so it was just a quick CT, and yeah, that's basically it. There wasn't really anything exciting to it. Went in, went out. Well, no, I definitely did not do that. I waited forever, but yeah, CT went good, but I just don't know the results. The results could be bad. Scan itself was okay, cool. I'm gonna stop talking now. Anyways, that's all I have to say. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so much. If you haven't already, subscribe. Just do it quick. Turn on the little bell. That's very, very important. Turn on the bell. Also, follow my other social medias. Links will be down below or at the end of the video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye guys. So you say you wanna get away. We don't need a plane. I could be your escape. Take you to a place.